This is Test Chamber. I'm Andrew Reiner. Jeff Cork's here.
Hello.
Jason Oestreicher's here.
Yo.
We're playing Disney Infinity. This is my character. I'm Captain Jack Sparrow from Pirates.
You look drunk.
I have the action figure on the base, and right here is your central hub, and there are four things you could do here. One of them is you could go to the Hall of Heroes, which we'll get to later. Second one is you could go on adventures. Third one is pretty cool, where you can spin the wheel to get new items for a toy box. And the fourth is the toy box, and I'm going to show you this. This is a world I built from hand, from scratch, with the help of Jeff Cork.
So this is like the combined mind of you two.
Yep, and
it's kind of scary.
It's not like Minecraft where I'm placing individual little blocks. It's more like a Tony Hawk level editor. That dates me a little bit, I know, but where you have set components, like you could see Scrooge's vault there, Epcot in the distance, this little Hall of Heroes. You know, these big slabs of land are things that I placed, and you could see where I connect them. You'll always see the seams. They want you to see the seams. I thought that was lame at first, but it kind of adds to that toy gimmick, mm-hmm. where, you know, every character is stylized, whether they're in Monsters, Inc. or Incredibles or Pirates, to all look like they belong in the same universe. They're all the same height. You know, Woody is supposed to be, you know, 6 inches tall, but he's mm-hmm. as tall as Jack. So I'm going to zoom out here and go into spark mode, and you could see how easy it is to just kind of get around here. And I will place one item, and then I'm going to have Jeff jump in co-op. Yahoo! You could do 4-player co-op online in this. Jeff and I are going to be showing off split screen. But I am going to show you just, I'm going to plop in, what should I plop in, Jeff? So here's a view, and it takes a little bit of time to kind of get around in these items, but you can also bring up the toy view, which gives you a wider look at what you have. And you don't start the game with all this stuff. One of the frustrating but really kind of cool elements of it is you unlock stuff as you play the other toy box games, which we'll get to in a bit. I'm going to lay down.
Reiner, there's a racetrack right there. Why are we not utilizing this?
We will in a second. I'm going to put this giant ship over here. And you see that green meter on the side? That is how much I can lay in the land. And, you know, we're just over half. Jeff will show you how you could break that. But you can see once it turns yellow, that means it's intersecting on that land and you could place it and it'll be flush. If I go here, it's too far. So I'm just going to throw this down. One thing, you can't do diagonals, so you're always turning at 90 degrees. Mm-hmm. So we'll put the ship there, and then I'm just going to get back out here into my world, and Jeff, why don't you come on in? All right, so Jeff's jumping in here, and this is my world. He can interact with it. He can do whatever he wants here.
We're the two decks.
Only I can save, though. I am Tonto. And these worlds, this is the cool thing. If you build it on Xbox 360, which we're playing on, it could be shared with PlayStation 3 and Wii U.
Wow.
So you can have the same play sets. You can't have, you know, someone playing on Xbox, someone playing on PS3. You got to be on the same system, but you could share your creation with other people. And Jeff's going to be building some stuff here. Jeff, see, here is your track, which you did not connect.
I know. I couldn't find the pieces to line up. So
I was so disappointed when I saw this.
Well, we haven't unlocked the start slash finish line, which could be like a super thin sliver.
There is my hot dog cart.
Okay.
Somehow misplaced underneath this. I'm going to show you something cool. And I built all this myself. Again, I didn't do block by block or pixel by pixel. I did just use some of the components that are available to me. So I placed this block here. And this ladder, I put this ladder on this ledge, so that isn't one piece there. You have to place that ladder. And then I line these up, these ledges up here, for a double jump. Jump here. Another ladder I place. This is going somewhere, I promise. This giant tree, which is really awesome. And
when do you unlock the elevator? Because that seems practical.
Yeah, that'd be nice, huh? I placed this thing from Monsters University. Which is a prank thing, which I lined all these up to get me up here.
Okay, screw practicality. That's fun.
Yeah, so you could just keep doing this kind of stuff all day long, and I think I know what Jeff's going to go do.
Yeah, and you added something to thwart this, right?
Yeah, I added a slingshot here.
All right.
For snipers. And
because we wanted to see.
So Jeff's going to be launching over Epcot, you could see. And he's going to try to fly through this hoop and land in this pool down here. But I'm going to try to. I got to get the range. Ooh, that looks pretty good.
Oh, it's time.
Whoa!
Oh!
What the hell did you nice land landing. In?
Oh, yeah. We added all those little bouncy things.
Yeah.
So Jeff and I were in my office playing this. Oh, did I get you?
You got me.
Jeff and I were in my office, and we were playing this for a good hour in silence, just building.
Yep.
And there's so much crazy stuff you could do. And they have pre-made worlds that they made using just these tools, Avalanche did, that just shows some crazy things. It's going to be really fun to see what people end up coming up with. Jeff added this this bridge system I'm not too crazy about. It kind of defeats the purpose of my bouncy thing. Oh, he's activating it. So Jeff's going to show how he broke
Here we go.
The memory. So these enemies are just going to keep spawning. And there's different switches you can add that can reset things. So you could do like an Angry Birds thing with that slingshot and have a big tower of blocks set up. And you could keep resetting it with like checkpoint system to show to have it reset so you could keep doing your challenge over and over and you don't have to set it up every time. So there's weapon play. Actually feels really nice. The Incredibles are probably the best characters in the game. I'm going to actually bring one out here as soon as I blow up this robot.
Hey, did that hit you?
So I'm going to go back into build view as soon as I get Mr. Incredible out here.
So I'm seeing an awful lot of sandbox stuff. There is an actual game here as well, correct?
There is a whole separate game where you unlock these components, and as soon as we're done here, we will jump into one of those modes. I put up this rail system. And as I said, this is one of the frustrating things. I don't have any straightaways when I built this. So I had to use all these curvy pieces to try to make it connect. But you will get straightaway pieces and stuff like that as you play the game. And I'm going to go do it over here. I'm going to go play the slot machine system to get new materials to use in my toy box. And you get these by playing the single player games by leveling up your characters. So here, Jeff, does anything here look appealing?
Get Puff the Magic Dragon.
Oh, it's okay. Elliot from Pete's Dragon.
Or Pete's Dragon, there we go.
All right, so I'm going to spin. I have 14 spins. Again, I got those from doing various things in the game or leveling up. Pride Rock, that's great. Mm-hmm. Whenever you get new materials to use, that's fantastic. Spin again. And then you could shuffle to get a different variety here. I know, Jeff, you were going for Scrooge's Vault.
Yes.
Hey, I
get it.
And this guy comes with a bonus, so I also got a new texture, modern. And I'm going to show you how that stuff works here. I'm just going to shuffle once just so you could see how it brings up a whole different variety of things to go for. But I'm going to go into this mode.
So here's Scrooge's Vault. Yes. You've got it here. Where you couldn't ordinarily get into it. What's up?
To your right's the adorable giraffe. I just saw him. There he is. Look at him. Jeff, don't do that. All right. Jeff, do it. Actually, I don't want to be here. I want to go.
All eyes on the right side of the screen right now.
So here you have the magic wand. Very Disney-esque. And
come
I'm just going to aim
get me
at
in there.
I'm going to aim at this and hit...
Oh, boo.
Hit Y to bring up the kingdom. And I'm going to theme it all. What theme should I do, Jeff? How about Monsters University?
Sounds great.
All right, so I'm going to do theme all, and the entire world is going to change. So everything just changed to Monsters University. Mind.
That's cool.
And then I'm going to shoot this tree... And I could just take it away, just boom, and it's gone. So as you get different things, you know, when Toy Story comes out, you'll be able to get the ability to grow and shrink items, I believe.
Yep. Well, here's some shrink goo
right
here. Yeah,
there's some shrink goo right there. So they have some stuff from Toy Story built in already. And then there are certain items in the world that you can aim at and, like, let's see here. I'm just going to change this one thing. So you don't have to theme it all as the same. I'm going to turn this to buried treasure. Just give it a little different look. So as you play the game, you'll unlock all sorts of these different things and be able to add them in. And it's super easy to play with, and there's a lot of things you could do. Jeff, let's go into a world. Which one do you want to do?
We got
Incredibles, pirates.
Let's do pirates.
Okay. We won't be able to do the dual Johnny Depps anymore, though.
Alas.
All of the characters in the Disney universe, and they launch with two Johnny Depps.
Yeah, he's kind of like the... is it Harrison Ford who's got a bunch of minifigs in Lego?
All right. All right, so let's go take a look at that. So in addition to the toy box, Disney Infinity ships with three separate standalone games. This is Pirates of the Caribbean, and there is also The Incredibles and Monsters University. Pirates was my favorite. Jeff, I know you've been playing this at home. You and I played quite a bit of this together.
Yeah, I was surprised. I like the Lone Ranger one a lot, too.
And that is an expansion set that you have to buy separately.
Correct.
That's day one as well. There's also cars.
Mm-hmm.
So you're not just characters with bipedal characters. You could also be vehicles in that toy box.
Exactly. Like
playing in that toy box.
And one of the things that's interesting about the different playsets is you unlock things as you progress through the story that you can then take into the toy box. Like when I built that ladder trying to get into Scrooge McDuck's vault, I used a ladder, like I said, but after playing through the Lone Ranger set, I had an ability that lets Tonto or anyone else turn into a crow.
Hmm.
And I was just able to fly, and you can indeed go inside of Scrooge's vault and jump into his gold and all that stuff. So
there's a bunch. It's an open world with a bunch of different areas and just missions. Anyone with you saw that exclamation point. Anyone you see will give you a mission, and you could stack them. So Jeff and I will probably just quickly get as many missions as we can and then just go nuts. There's a nice waypoint system.
How well does it handle you guys going different directions?
Pretty well. You're always going to be kind of in the same world. Like, there's a full-on like Assassin's Creed pirate ship section to this game where you actually are on the high seas. There are side islands you could go to. With that kind of Zelda-esque thing where, well, we need a bomb item to be able to get through this wall. We don't have that yet. We got to come back later. Just a ton of stuff to do in this game. And I would say each little game is 4 to 5 hours with the potential for more if you're going for gold medals and all the challenges and trying to get 100%.
There are a lot of capsules, too, that, again, bring things into the toy box mode as well. So you're encouraged to kind of explore.
Yeah, and I don't think you'll see a lot of those capsules because I've gotten a lot of them so far.
I just saw one right out of the gate, so what? I'm wondering if it...
My vision's going really bad.
I wonder if it just repopulates if you play again.
So there's sword play, there's also a gun. Boom. And then, you know, you'll be able to bring most of these items into your toy box. Not just, you know, things you're getting, but the actual mechanics for the gameplay.
One of the biggest gripes that I had about Skylanders is like the paywalls, essentially. You'd get into a level and you see an area that you really want to get into, but no, you've got to go buy this particular figure. Is there anything like that in the main game?
Yeah, there are. You'll find some vaults where you need all three characters from a specific... Like, you need all five Incredibles characters to be able to open the vault.
Oh, wow.
And once you open the vault, they reward you well. They'll spit out, like, 6 or 7 different things you could use. But, and then when you're in your toy box, you'll also see periodically, like, there'll be a little box that shows up for the Tangled Girl or Jack Skellington. Mm-hmm. And it's like, I don't have those characters. It's in my toy world. It's just reminding me to go buy them. And it even does that Skylanders thing of play a video.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to see if we could buy anything yet, Jeff. So there's a little toy store in here. So you can see all these things. These are all for the ship.
Yeah.
So once you get your ship, you're going to upgrade it with all sorts of crazy powers, including a Kraken hammer, which summons a Kraken, and...
What?
Oh, man, I found one, too. Awesome. So Privateer here, they have their own little Lego characters. If you played Toy Story 3, which is basically the prequel to this game, they have these little Lego characters that you could dress up in the toy box and in some of the worlds. And they're adorable, and... A lot of the missions have to do with dressing these guys up. So it tells its own story. It's not doing the exact movies.
No, and you can't pull in, like, we couldn't pull Mr. Incredible into this. They try to stay pretty faithful to whatever license it is.
Yep, only in the toy box can you kind of mix and match.
And this is probably just... my individual problem, but I like to break crates. And if you're watching my side of the screen, you see I'm just going in a circle right now because there's a nice, a pretty short respawn time for when the crates reappear and coins pop out. So,
and I've here's one of those boxes I was talking about. So this one's for Jack. I've already unlocked it. So if you didn't have him, Jack Sparrow, you wouldn't be able to open this.
Oh, I see. Okay,
but you do get him in the playset. Let's see, they want me to go up. Oh, I'm, like, blown up in these doors.
Now you can change out your guys on the fly. Like, you've got Jack Sparrow over there.
Yep, I could throw in Jack. I could throw, you know, Barbossa. But there's only three characters available. Yeah, here's one of those.
Mm-hmm.
Only three characters available for pirates. So Skylanders, you know, they have 30 characters and they all work in the same game. Once you're in these little play sets, you can only use the characters from that universe.
Gotcha.
So it is like its own little mini game, and this one's a lot of fun. Incredibles is pretty good. Monsters, Inc., which is all non-violent, and I applaud them for attempting that. A lot of fetch quests, just a kind of different vibe. Actually, let's show that right now. All right, here we are in Monsters University on the campus. And Jeff is showing off. You have different items you could play with. There's a toilet paper launcher, so I can TP these walls here, yeah, or these trees. But it's all nonviolent. There's...
That's what I did in college.
Except for all these bombs I'm throwing.
Those are fireworks, Jeff.
Oof.
You can... This is... I was talking about those little monsters that you'll find. You can pick them up and... You could throw them around. You could decorate them. So I'm going to pick up this little girl here. And I'm going to take her. So I could drop kick her.
That's not what you do when you pick up chicks.
Right? But she's okay. She still likes me.
Okay.
And I'm going to throw her into this this booth here to change her clothing. In she goes. So here's the... customizer, and it's very much like Toy Story 3 Avalanche's precursor to this game, which is basically the same kind of game. Like, that is kind of the prequel to this game. So change her color. We'll give her like a little snake tail, super nice
scary stash.
Ooh, yeah, how about that? See what she looks like.
Beautiful.
Excellent. And then you leave and there she is. So there's your new version to pick up and drop kick. See you later. A lot of verticality in most of the levels.
Really?
There is a tower over here. So you'll be able to get up on top of that building. And I'll show you here.
Do you mind if I buy some stuff?
Yeah, go for it.
All right.
You're gonna do some. Oh, you got me some points there. And it takes a while to level up characters. You can see Randall, who I didn't really play as, or Randy. What's his name? Randy.
Randy.
You can see he's level 0. My Sully is level 7.
Whoa, what's that?
So this just kind of opens up a platforming section. So I'm up here. You can rail slide. You can just keep exploring. Can I make that jump?
Back for more.
Nope.
See ya.
So that's the delivery bug.
Oh, okay, I was just looking for where the packages are going to be.
That's how you get new items. It's a little annoying because you got to keep coming back here when you go to different worlds. And there are three big hubs like this for monsters. Three or four, actually.
What are you riding?
The rival school's mascot.
Yeah, he's on a little pig. Oh, here's a...
Guy,
he's going to throw stuff at me and try to hurt me. And you could try to take him down, but you're not going to hurt them, like, big time. You won't kill them or anything. But that's kind of one of the challenges that they face is how do they make exciting gameplay for 4 or 5 hours that isn't violent? And I know that sounds like, well, just don't make it violent. But, you know, a lot of it is fetch quests. I think that is kind of the weakest link of this one.
Well, if you look at my screen, I'm getting beaten up a lot. So it's not entirely.
Those guys are more hazards. You could shoot at them, but you won't really be able to take them down. You could scare them, which will knock them out. I'm going to climb around here.
And you've already done... Yeah, you've done that one. The challenge? You want to do a challenge?
Yeah, we could show off a challenge.
Awesome!
So here it is. Jeff's going to start it, and then it gives me a view invitees. I hit A, challenge, and it's just going to bring me right there, which is really nice.
What if you declined it? You wouldn't be able to do it?
No. Here's the time limit. This is one without a bike. Yeah. You get a bike in this one, which is kind of cool. Oops, there he is. Wrong button.
Fantastic.
And up to... So we're doing the hardest one, which is 50. There's three levels for each one, and you could just stand there and pump them out one after another, which is kind of cool. And...
Not gonna lie, Reiner, I'm not doing so great here.
That's what I'm talking about.
Oh, you're both collecting.
We're doing horrible, aren't we?
Yeah.
How'd that happen?
I blame myself.
I couldn't see what happened over there. I think I got like 36 of those. 38. Alright, so we failed that. But that's a look at monsters. Let's go take a look at two other things in the game and then we'll call it a day. All right, we're warping into the Hall of Heroes. This is just a little hub world where...
Find ourselves another adventure.
Jeff's going to destroy it now. It just shows you all the pogs. That's a key component of this game. I'm actually going to put one under Jeff. Stand up, Jeff. No, I'm going to put it under your character. So he got Bolt's pog... which are these little discs that you could buy in kind of like baseball card packs. They're blind packs. You don't know who you're getting. But you could stack them then, and I'm going to add another one to Jeff. So your figure is actually standing on these pogs.
Robin Hood.
Oh, yeah. There's all sorts of... There's Muppets. You'll see those guys. You can't play as them.
Aw.
But you can see all the statues in the background, and... They're not saying the kid or the wife is less important than Mr. Incredible. He's being silver, they're bronze. That's the level of your characters that determines the color of the statue. So if you get to level 15, maybe it's 10 or 15, you're going to turn them gold. And then you get a spin for that, I believe, to use
just
in
like
the toy box.
One playthrough or multiple?
Yeah, you got to keep... You know, one playthrough... only got me up to like level 7.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So getting up to 15, you get experience for doing things in the toy box, which is kind of surprising in my opinion, but not a lot. Like you would have to play a lot of this game to do it. And I don't know, maybe if you play through the campaign again, maybe that would do it.
All right.
But then Jeff's going to go here. You need to go to the, or maybe in travel. Might be able to do it there. Jeff's going to take a look at an adventure.
Should I do a mastery adventure?
Nope, those are just training. Adventures are these pre-made challenges by Avalanche. And the first one Jeff picked there is... The first one is always unique to the characters, so they always have an exclusive challenge. Kind of like Skylanders with their stages.
And you said these are all built with the Toy Box tools.
These are all using Toy Box tools. And assets, yep.
All right.
And they get kind of crazy. Like, there's some races with this guy you're seeing right now. His track is gigantic. So you can see all the seams, some of the same trees I had in my world.
To rescue the townspeople, destroy the domes before time runs out.
All right.
Lost snow.
So now we got that bolt. Don't call it a pog, whatever they get, the power disc.
Yeah.
So
slight advantage. And Jeff, if you get 3 gold medals, you get 100 achievement points.
Oh my gosh. All right.
You're going to do your ground pound?
Yes, and then fall down.
There you go.
Nice.
So playing as all the Incredibles is a lot of fun. These guys, they're all really different. You know, this challenge particularly, you can only use Mr. Incredible. It's his exclusive one. But they're pretty fun. Some of them are really tough. Like, I found some of them to be pretty unfair. And then... Yeah, you see the waypoint system. You could use that in all missions. You could always... any mission you're on, just say, don't step on those, by the way.
Good Lord, it just keeps shooting me into it. And you just fall apart. It's absolutely gruesome.
No more screw-ups. I am ready this time.
Oh, boy. There we go.
I don't think you're going to complete this one. You will get a bronze for getting 2 of them.
Actually, it shouldn't be bad once I get in here. He said.
Yeah, those rocket guys are a serious problem. But they're pretty easy to kill.
Whoa, right on that.
That was awesome.
That's like trapped.
So you could get those traps for your playset. You could set up stuff like this. I'm not good enough to figure out how to tie all these little tiles together to tell it to... It takes 6 hits to break this dome and all that kind of stuff.
But that's
stuff you could do in the game. There's different ways to activate things, link things together so they work together.
Go, Cork.
Where am I going now?
I don't know.
Give me a waypoint. There we go. Oh, this is a cinch. You're going to get a gold medal.
I don't want that curvy bridge. That's nice.
I want Boy, that I want to get out of this stun lock scenario here. There we go.
Good job.
Get up there.
Oh, brother.
Look at all these guys.
God, no.
I think that's more than you had spawned at once.
All right, if I get on this side, just let me beat this up.
Oh, and there's a big guy here, dude. Good luck.
I just want to rescue Snow White.
How many snows are in this world?
Good grief.
You watch Once Upon a Time?
Nope.
You should. It's a good show.
I used to.
Why'd you give up?
They electrocuted Pinocchio with a taser. That was too much? Yeah, that was too much. I was done at that point.
What did that do to his nose?
Oh, it killed him.
Oh.
Yeah. I mean, spoilers, but...
Poor Pinocchio.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Jeff, God. I don't know if you're going to do this, dude.
I really want to, though.
12. 19 seconds. Oh, man. Oh, man, you're going to make this exciting for a silver medal.
Get up, you idiot.
Oh, so close. 5.
Oh, no.
Whoa. Come on.
In my heart.
I am so mad.
Wow. And you got...
Wow. That's a hell of a way to go out,
though. You got a silver. You almost had gold.
Almost didn't put a gold medal in your pocket, though, Reiner.
Well, that's Disney Infinity. It really is... A lot of fun. Jeff, what do you think of it so far?
It's great. I'm having a really good time with it.
And you're playing it with your boys.
Mm-hmm.
Are they having problems? Have they tried the
Every
toy
time
box
we
yet?
Stop playing, they cry. So, success.
Have they tried the toy box, though?
Yeah. Yep.
And they're able to build stuff?
Not so much.
Just placing trees in the sky and stuff like that?
Trying to, yeah. A lot of that. But
And you get a look there of some things that are coming out later. There's Tangled. That bike you could get in the toy box, mm-hmm. All that stuff. But thanks for watching, everyone. I highly recommend you check it out. It is a little spendy. You know, just the initial price is more than your standard game. But and then the additional figures cost more money. But what you get out of the box is well worth it. There's a lot of game there. You get those 3 worlds, the toy box, all those challenges. And then from there, if you like it, you could build on it for sure. I can't wait to see what comes next year. Disney has Star Wars now. You got to think that they got to be thinking about that for 2015. They have all the Marvel licenses. They have the Muppets. The sky really is the limit for what they can do with this moving forward and what properties they can use. But they're off to a great start, and as I said, I can't wait to see where it goes from here. So thanks for watching, everyone. We'll see you next time on Test Chamber.